So let's take a look at how to set margins and page size in Pages. So in this example I'm just going to use a standard blank document template. And let's turn some things on so we can really see what we're dealing with here. So under View, first I want to show the rulers. So I can see here I've got inches as my measurement. And I'm going to also show Layout. So you can see the body text here. And you can really see that it starts at 1 inch from the left, and there's 1 inch on the right, and there's a full inch at the top and bottom. Now, switching the margins is really easy. All you need to do is go to the Document sidebar. So click Document here, and then go to the Document Margin section here. So for instance, if I wanted a 2 inch margin on the left, I could just change this number to 2, and you can see everything shrinks on the left. Even the header and footer make way for this extra margin. So you can set these to whatever you want. So setting margins is actually pretty easy. Document size is a little different. Here you've got a printer and paper size at the top, and you can select which printer you want, but you know, really doesn't matter which printer you use. It's the paper type here that matters. Now notice you can choose from a bunch of standard paper sizes like an A4 or US Letter or US Legal, but you don't have the ability to actually set the numbers here. But you can. All you need to do is go to File and then Page Setup. And here under Paper Size you can manage custom sizes. So I already have one set. We can create a new one with the plus button and we can give it whatever name we want. So test size, and say you've got paper that is 6 inches by 9 inches. And then don't worry about the non-printable area. That doesn't seem to have too much of an effect in most cases, although Apple does suggest setting those to zeros all around if you're having difficulty. But I've never run into a situation where that's come into play. So I hit OK, and now you can see my unusual size here. I can select it over here, but I first need to go switch to any printer. So then I can see these custom ones here. I find that if I select a specific printer, at least in my case, then things don't show up correctly there. So setting it to any printer, and I can use that custom size or go back to a regular size. And you can still adjust the document margins as before. This is just basically giving yourself a head start here if you are using an unusual paper size with Pages.